instead of being committed to something. So, Earl Pierce, here on behalf of Unitil. I'm not going to tell you anything that you haven't already heard. We are opposed to the bill as introduced, and we're certainly not against reporting loss in unaccounted gas. We can only provide that to the PUC as you encourage. And annually we do that in compliance with what they call the pipeline and hazardous materials safety administration 7105. But for the record, that's what it is. We do have concerns with section 2A on line 16 to identify and measure all sources, that language. It's due to the dispersed nature of the underground gas system. Identifying these discrete locations for lost gas is really not practical. Other than this concern, we're not opposed to the bill, and note that the premise would be redundant given our current reporting requirements, and we take no position on section 2 regarding electric distribution companies' investment in national gas.
Thank you very much, Mr. Pierce. Any questions?
Yes, again, it's my understanding that similar legislation was put forth in Massachusetts. Would you be able to speak to that and how you've been able to comply with that legislation or not comply?
I'm not sure. Unitil does have gas assets in Massachusetts, and I'm not sure where they are. I can certainly get an answer from Carlton Simpson for you. And the question is, how are we compliant in Massachusetts with that? Okay.
Thank you very much for your time.